Good day. Today our first topic is integration of binomial differentials. An expression of the form x to the power of m times a plus b x to the power of n to the power of p dx, where m, n, p, a, b are constants, is called a binomial differential. Theorem. The integral of a binomial differential integral of x to the power of m times a plus b x to the power of n to the power of p dx, if m, n, p are rational numbers, is reduced to an integral of a rational function and thus is expressed in terms of elementary functions in the following three cases. Is reduced to an integral of a rational function and thus is expressed in terms of elementary functions. in the following three cases. The first case. P is a integer. Positive, negative, or zero. The second. N plus 1 over N is an integer. Positive, negative, or 0. And the third case. N plus 1 over N plus P. Oh, sorry. Over N. Plus P is an integer. Positive, negative, or 0. Transform the given integral by substitution. X is z to the power of 1 over n. In this case, the x will be equal to 1 over n times z to the power of 1 over n minus 1 dz. Then, integral of x to the power of n times a plus bx to the power of n to the power of p dx will be equal to 1 over n integral of z to the power of n plus 1 over n minus 1 times a plus b z to the power of p dz, or 1 over n times integral of z to the power of q a plus bz to the power of p dz. Formula 1, where q is m plus 1 over n minus 1. The first. Let P be an integer. Since Q is a rational number, we denote it by R over S. Integral 1 is then of the form integral of R, rational function of z to the power of R over S, z, with respect to x. As we pointed on our last lecture, it reduces to an integral of a rational function by the substitution z is t to the power of s. The second, let m plus 1 over n be an integral. Then q is m plus 1 over n minus 1 is also integer. The number p is rational. P is lambda over mu. Here the integral 1 is of the form integral of rational function of x to the power of q a plus b z to the power of lambda over mu with respect to x. This integral was considered in our last lecture. It reduces to an integral of a rational function by the substitution a plus bz equals t to the power of mu. The third, let m plus 1 over n plus p be an integer. But then m plus 1 over n minus 1 plus p equals q plus p is an integer. We transform integral 1 z to the power of q times a plus bz to the power of p dz equals integral of z to the power of q plus p times a plus bz over z to the power of p dz. where q plus p is an integer and p is k over L, is a rational number. The latter integral belongs to the class of integral of rational function of z and a plus bz over z to the power of k over L. This is it. This integral was considered as later. It reduces to an integral of a rational function by the substitution a plus bz over z. Is t to the power of L. Let us examine examples of integration in all the three cases. Example 1. Integral of dx over cubed root of x squared times 1 plus cubed root of x squared equals integral of x to the power of minus 2 over 3 times 1 plus x to the power of 2 over 3 to the power of minus 1 with respect to x. Here p is minus 1 integer. Putting x to the power 2 over 3 is z, we make the quantity in parentheses linear in z. Our integral will be equal to integral of z to the power minus 1, 1 plus z to the power minus 1, 3 over 2, z to the power 1 over 2, dz home, 3 over 2, integral of z to the power minus 1 over 2, 1 plus z to the power of minus 1 dz. Now make the substitution z to the power 1 of 1 over 2 is t, then that is t squared, dz is 2t dt. And our integral equal to 3 over 2 integral of z to the power minus 1 over 2, 1 plus z to the power of minus 1 dz, or 3 over 2 integral of t to the power minus 1, 1 plus t squared to the power of minus 1 to t dt, or 3 integral of ds, dt over 1 plus t squared, or 3 arctangent of t plus c, 3 arctangent of square root of z plus c, or 3 arctangent of cubed root of x plus c. Example 2. Integral of x cubed over square root of 1 minus x squared dx equals integral of x cubed 1 minus x squared to the power minus 1 over 2 dx. Here m is 3, n is 2, p is minus 1 over 2, m plus 1 over n is 2 integral. We substitute x squared is z, then x is z to the power 1 over 2, dx is 1 over 2 times z to the power minus 1 over 2 dz, and our integral will be equal to integral of z to the power 3 over 2, 1 minus z to the power of minus 1 over 2 times 1 over 2 times z to the power minus 1 over 2. Or 1 over 2 integral of z times 1 minus z to the power of minus 1 over 2 dz. In order to make the second parenthesis rational, we put 1 minus z to the power 1 over 2 is t. Then 1 minus z is t squared, z is t squared minus 1, dz is 2t dt. Hence our integral equals 1 over 2 times integral of t squared minus 1 times t to the power of minus 1 times 2t dt equals integral of t squared minus 1 dt equals t cubed over 3 minus t plus c equals t over 3 times t squared minus 2 plus c equals square root of 1 minus z over 3 times minus z minus 2 plus c on 1 over 3 square root of 1 minus x squared times minus x squared minus 2 plus c. Example 3. integral of dx over x squared times square root of 1 plus x squared cubed equals integral of x to the power of minus 2 1 plus x squared to the power of minus 3 over 2 dx. Here m is minus 2, n is 2, p is 3 over 2, minus 3 over 2. And m plus 1 over n plus p is minus 2, it means integral. We reduce this expression in the parentheses to a linear function, x squared is z, x is z to the power of 1 over 2, dx will be equal to 1 over 2 times z to the power of minus 1 over 2 dz. And our integral equals integral of z to the power minus 1, 1 plus z to the power of minus 3 over 2 times 1 over 2, z to the power of minus 1 over 2 dz equals 1 over 2 times integral z to the power minus 3 over 2, 1 plus z to the power minus 3 over 2 dz, or 1 over 2 integral of z to the power minus 3, 1 plus z over z to the power of minus 3 over 2 dz. The first factor is a rational function in order to make the second factor rational as well. We make the substitution 1 plus z over z to the power of 1 over 2 is t. Here 1 plus z over z is t squared, z is 1 over t squared minus 1, and dz equals minus 2t dt over t squared minus 1 squared. Thus, our integral equals 1 over 2 integral of t squared minus 1 cubed t to the power of minus 3 times minus 2t dt over t squared minus 1 squared. Minus integral of t squared minus 1 over t squared dt, or minus integral of dt plus integral of dt over t squared, or minus t minus 1 over t plus c, that equal to minus 1 plus z over z to the power of 1 over 2 minus z over 1 plus z to the power of 1 over 2 plus sin o minus 1 plus x squared over x squared to the power of 1 over 2 minus x squared over 1 plus x squared to the power of 1 over 2 plus c o minus square root of 1 plus x squared here 2 squared over x minus x over square root of 1 plus x squared plus c. They noted mathematician Chebyshev proved that only in the above three cases in an integral of binomial differentials with rational exponents expressed in terms of elementary functions, provided of course that a don't equal to zero and b don't equal to zero, but that neither p nor n plus 1 over n nor n plus 1 over n plus p are integrals, then the integral cannot be expressed in terms of elementary functions. Our now next subtitle, integration of certain classes of trigonometric functions. Up to now, we have made a systematic study only of the integral of algebraic functions, rational or irrational. In this section, in this topic, we shall consider integrals of certain classes of non-algebraic functions. Primarily trigonometric. Let us consider an integral of the form integral of rational function of sine of x cosine of x dx, formula 1. We shall show that the integral by the substitution tangent of x over 2 is t, formula 2, always reduces to an integral of a rational function. Let us express sine of x and cosine of x in terms of tangent of x over 2 and hence in terms of t. Sine of x equals 2 sine of x over 2 times cosine of x over 2 over 1, or 2 sine, oh sorry, of x over 2 times cosine of x over 2 over sine squared of x over 2 plus cosine squared of x over 2. Or if we divided both numerator and denominator by cosine squared of x over 2, we will have that our ratio equals to tangent of x over 2 over 1 plus tangent squared of x over 2 or 2t over 1 plus t squared, since t is tangent of x over 2. Cosine of x equals cosine squared of x over 2 minus sine squared of x over 2 over 1. Or cosine squared of x over 2 minus sine squared of x over 2 over cosine squared of x over 2 plus sine squared of x over 2. If we divide both numerator and denominator by cosine squared of x over 2, we will have that our expression will be equal to minus 1 minus tangent squared of x over 2 over 1 plus tangent squared of x over 2 or 1 minus t squared over 1 plus t squared. And x is 2 arctangent of t, dx will be equal to 2 dt over 1 plus t squared. In this way, sine of x, cosine of x, and dx are expressed rationally in terms of t. Since a rational function of rational functions is a rational function, by substituting the expressions obtained into the integral 1, we get an integral of a rational function, integral of r of sine of x and cosine of x with respect to x will be equal to integral of r of 2t over 1 plus t squared, 1 minus t squared over 1 plus t squared times 2 dt over 1 plus minus t squared. Consider the example, example 1. Consider the integral dx over sine of x. On the basis of the foregoing formulas, we have that this integral will be equal 2 dt over 1 plus t squared over 2t over 1 plus t squared, or just integral of dt over t, or natural logarithm of modulus of t plus c, or natural logarithm of modulus of tangent of x over 2 plus c. The substitution enables us to integrate any function of the form r of cosine of x, sine of x. For this reason, it is sometimes called universal trigonometric substitution. It is t is tangent of x over 2, this substitution number 2. However, in practice, it frequently leads to extremely complex rational function. It is therefore convenient to know some other substitutions in addition to the universal one that sometimes lead more quickly to the desired end. The first if an integral is of the form integral of r of sine of x times cosine of x dx, the substitution sine of x equals t and cosine of x dx equals dt reduces this integral to the form integral of r of t dt. The second case. If the integral has the form integral of r of cosine of x times sine of x dx, it is reduces to an integral of a rational function by the substitution cosine of x is t, sine of x times dx is minus dt. And in this case, we will have minus integral of r of t dt. The third case. If the integrand is dependent only on tangent of x, then the substitutions tangent of x is t x is arctangent of t, dx is dt over 1 plus t squared, reduces this integral to an integral of a rational function, integral of r of t dt over 1 plus t squared. The fourth case. If the integrand had the form r of sine of x and cosine of x, But sine of x and cosine of x are involved only in even powers. When the same substitution is applied, tangent of x is t, formula 2 prime. Because sine square root of x and cosine square root of x are expressed rationally in terms of tangent of x, cosine square root of x will be equal 1 over 1 plus tangent square root of x, or 1 over 1 plus t square root, and sine square root of x equals tangent square root of x over this denominator, or t square root over 1 plus t square root, and dx will be equal to dt over 1 plus t square root. After the substitution, we obtain an integral of a rational function. Consider the example, example 2. Compute the integral of sine cubed of x 2 plus cosine of x dx. This integral is readily reduced in the form r of cosine of x sine of x dx. Indeed, this integral equals integral of sine square root of x sine of x dx over 2 plus cosine of x, or integral of 1 minus cosine square root of x over 2 plus cosine of x times sine of x dx. We make the substitution cosine of x equals z, then sine of x dx will be equal to minus dz. And we have that our integral equals 1 minus z squared root over 2 plus z minus dz. Or z squared root minus 1 over z plus 2 dz, integral of it, equals integral of z minus 2 plus 3 over z plus 2 with respect to z, equals z squared over 2 minus 2z plus 3 natural logarithm of z plus 2 plus c equals cosine squared of x over 2 minus 2 cosine of x plus 3 natural logarithm of cosine of x plus 2 plus c. The next example, example 3. Compute integral of dx over 2 minus sine squared of x. Make the substitution. Tangent of x equals t. We have integral of dt over 2 minus t squared over 1 plus t squared times 1 plus t squared into the denominator equals integral of dt over 2 plus t squared or 1 over square root of 2 times arctangent of t over square root of 2 plus c or 1 over square root of 2 arctangent of tangent x over square root of 2 plus c. The 5 space. Now let us consider one more integral of the form integral of r of sine of x cosine of x dx, namely an integral under the sine of which there is the product sine to the power of m of x times cosine to the power of n of x dx, where m and n is integer. Here we shall have to consider 3 cases. A. Integral of sine to the power of m of x times cosine to the power of n of x dx, where m and n such that at least one of them is odd. For definiteness, let us assume that n is odd. Put n is 2, p plus 1, and transform the integral. Integral of sine to the power of m of x times cosine to the power of 2e plus 1 of x dx equals integral of sine of x to the power of n times cosine of x to the power of 2p times cosine of x times dx, or integral of sine to the power of m of x times 1 minus sine square root of x to the power of p times cosine of x dx. Change the variable sine of x is t, cosine of x dx is dt. Putting the new variable into the given integral, we get integral of t to the power of m, 1 minus t squared to the power of p dt, which is an integral of a rational function of t. Example 4. Integral of cosine square root of x over sine to the power of 4 of x dx equals integral of cosine here cubed, not square root, cosine square root of x times cosine of x over sine to the power of 4 of x dx, or integral of 1 minus sine square root of x times cosine of x dx over sine to the power of 4 of x. Denoting sine of x is t, cosine of x dx is dt, we get integral of 1 minus t squared over t to the power of 4 dt, or integral of dt over t to the power of 4 minus integral of dt over t squared. Equals minus 1 over 3 t cubed plus 1 over t plus c, or minus 1 over 3 sine cubed of x plus 1 over sine of x plus c. The case B. Integral of sine to the power of m of x times cosine to the power of n of x with respect to x, where m and n are non-negative and even number. put m is 2p, n is 2u. Write the familiar trigonometric formulas. Sine square root of x is 1 over 2 minus 1 over 2 times cosine of 2x. And cosine square root of x is 1 over 2 plus 1 over 2 times cosine of 2x. Formula 3. Putting them into the integral, we get integral of sine of 2p of x times cosine of 2p of x with respect to x equals integral of 1 over 2 minus 1 over 2 times cosine of 2x to the power of p, 1 over 2 plus 1 over 2 times cosine of 2x to the power of q with respect to x. Over an opening brackets, we get terms containing cosine of 2x in odd or even powers. The terms with odd powers are integrated as indicated in case A. We again reduce the even exponents by formula 3. Continuing in this manner, we arrive at terms of the form of integral of cosine of kx with respect to x. Which can easily be integrated. Consider the example, example 5. Integral of sine to the power of 4 of x with respect to x equals 1 over 2 squared integral of 1 minus cosine of 2x to the power of 2 dx, or 1 over 4 integral 1 minus 2 cosine of 2x plus cosine square root of 2x dx, or 1 over 4 x minus sine of 2x plus 1 over 2 times integral of 1 plus cosine of 4x dx equals 1 over 4 times 3 over 2x minus sine of 2x plus sine of 4x over 8 plus c. Next case, case c. If both exponents are even and at least one of them is negative, then the preceding technique does not give the desired result. Where one should make the substitution tangent of x is t. Or cosine of x is t. Oh, cotangent, sorry. Example 6. Integral of sine square root of x dx over cosine to the power of 4 of x, or 6 of x, equals integral sine square root of x times sine square root of x plus cosine square root of x square root over cosine to the power of 6 of x dx, or integral of tangent square root of x times 1 plus tangent square root of x square root dx. And after substitution, tangent of x is t, we will have integral of t squared root, 1 plus t squared root squared root dt over 1 plus t squared root. Integral of t squared times 1 plus t squared dt, or t cubed over 3 plus t to the power of 5 over 5 plus c, or tangent cubed over x over 3 plus tangent to the power of 5 over x over of x over 5 plus c. The sixth case. In conclusion, let us consider integrals the form integral of cosine of nx times cosine of nx dx, integral of sine of mx times cosine of nx dx, and integral of sine of mx, sorry, times sine of nx with respect to x. They are taken by means of the following formulas: if m don't equal to n, cosine of mx times cosine of nx equals 1 over 2 times cosine of m plus n x plus cosine of m minus n x. Sine of mx times cosine of nx equals 1 over 2 times sine of m plus nx plus sine of m minus nx. And sine of mx times sine of nx is 1 over 2 times minus cosine of m plus nx plus cosine of m minus nx. Substituting and integrating, we get, for example, integral of cosine of nx times cosine of nx with respect to x equals 1 over 2, integral of sum of cosine of sum m and n and difference of these values. Or we have sine of n plus n x over 2 m plus n plus sine of m minus n x over 2 m minus n plus c. The other two integrals are evaluated similarly. Consider the example. Example 7. In which we must compute the integral sine of 5x times sine of 3x dx. It was 1 over 2 integral minus cosine of 5 plus 3 is 8x plus cosine of 5 minus 3 is 2x dx, or minus sine of 8x over 16 plus sine of 2x over 4 plus c. Very easy. Next subtitle, integration of certain irrational functions by means of trigonometric substitution. By means of trigonometric substitution. Let us return to the integral of r of x and square root of ax squared plus bx plus c with respect to x. Formula 1. Here we shall give a method of transforming this integral into one of the form integral of r with the upper line of sine of z and cosine of z with respect to z. It's 2. Which was considered in the preceding subtitle. Transform the trinomial under the radical sine. Sorry. transform the trinomial under the radical sign ax squared plus bx plus c is a times x plus b over 2a squared plus c minus b squared over 4a. Change the variable putting x is plus b over 2a is t. In this case, dx will be equal to dt. Then, square root of ax squared plus bx plus c will be equal to square root of at squared plus c minus b squared over 4a. Let us consider all possible cases. The first, let a is greater than 0, c minus b squared over 4a is greater than 0. We introduce the designation a is m squared, c minus b over 2a is n squared. In this case, square root of ax squared plus bx plus c will be equal to square root of m squared t squared plus n squared. The second case. Let a greater than 0, c minus b squared over 4a is less than 0. Then a is m squared, c minus b squared over 4a is minus n squared. Thus, square root of ax squared plus bx plus c will be equal to square root of m squared t squared minus n squared. The third case. Let a is less than 0, c minus b squared over 4a is greater than 0. Then a is minus m squared, c minus b squared over 4a is n squared. Hence, square root of ax squared plus bx plus c equals square root of n squared minus m squared t squared. The form. Let a is less than 0 and c minus b squared over 4a is less than 0 too. In this case, square root of ax squared plus bx plus c, a complex number for every values of x. In this way, integral 1 is reduced to one of the following types of integral. The first integral of r of t and square root of m squared t squared plus n squared dt 3 1. The second integral of r of t and square root of m squared t squared minus n squared dt. And the third integral of r of t and square root of n squared minus m squared t squared dt. 3 3. Obviously, integral 3 1 is reduced to the integral of the form by the substitution t is n over m. Times tangent of z. Integral 3 2 is reduced to the form 2 by the substitution c is n over m times second of that. Integral 3 3 is reduced to two by the substitution c is m over n, n over m. Times sine of t. Consider the example. Compute the integral of dx over square root of a squared minus x squared cubed. Solution. This integral of type 3. Make the substitution x is a times sine of z. Dx in this case will be equal to the derivative of x, it means a times cosine of z dz, and our integral will be equal to integral of a cosine of z dz over square root of a squared minus a squared sine squared of z cubed. Equals integral of a cosine of z dz over a cubed cosine cubed of z on 1 over a squared integral dz over cosine squared of z on 1 over a squared tangent of z plus c on 1 over a squared sine of z over cosine of z plus c or 1 over a squared times sine of z over square root of 1 minus sine squared of z plus c or 1 over a squared times x over square root of a squared minus x squared plus c. Next, subtitle, function whose integrals cannot be expressed in terms of elementary function. We pointed out that any function f of x continuous on the interval from n to b has an antiderivative on this interval. In other words, there exists a function f of x such that f prime of x is a little f of x. However, not every antiderivative, even when it exists, is expressible in final form in terms of elementary function. For instance, we have already pointed out that the antiderivative of binomial differential that do not belong to the three examined types cannot be expressed in terms of elementary function in final form. Consider Chebyshev's theorem. Such are the antiderivative expressed by the integral of e to the power minus x squared dx, integral of sine of x over x dx, integral of cosine of x over x dx, integral of square root of 1 minus k squared times sine squared of x with respect to x, integral of dx over natural logarithm of x, and many other. In all such cases, the antiderivative is obviously some new function which does not reduce to a combination of a finite number of elementary functions. For example, that one of the antiderivatives, integral of e to the power minus x squared dx plus c, which vanishes for x is 0, is called the Gauss functions and is denoted by phi, big phi of x. If phi of 0 is 0. This function has been studied in detail. Tables of its values for various values of x have been completed. We shall see how this is done in our next themes. Now we consider other antiderivative, the integral of square root of 1 minus k squared times sine squared of x with respect to x plus c, phi is less than 1, which vanishes for x is 0, is called an elliptic integral, and denoted by e of x. If e of 0 is 0. Tables of the values of this function have also been compiled for various values of x. The second part of our classes today, we will solve the example with this practical classes. And first number that we will solve, the number 54. We must integrate tangent cubed of x over cosine squared of x with respect to x. We know that derivative of tangent is 1 over cosine squared of x. It means we can take the substitution t is tangent of x. In this case, dt will be equal to dx over cosine squared of x. And we have integral of t cubed dt. It means t to the power of 4 over 4 plus c equals tangent to the power of 4 of x over 4 plus c. Next number, number 56. Integral of cosine of 2x over 2 plus 3 sine of 2x with respect to x. In this case, we can take substitute t is 2 plus 3 times sine of 2x. In this case, dt will be 6 cosine of 2x dx, and we have 1 over 6 integral of dt over t, or 1 over 6 times natural logarithm of t plus constant c is 1 over 6 natural logarithm of 2 plus 3 sine of 2x plus c. Next number, number 58. 'Tis integral of cosine of a plus bx with respect to x. In this case, we take t is a plus bx, dt is b dx, or 1 over b integral of cosine of t dt equals 1 over b times sine of t plus c equals 1 over b times sine of a plus bx plus c. Next number, number 16. We have integral of e to the power of x over 3 with respect to x. It means we must take t is x over 3, dt is dx over 3. In our case, we have 3 integral e to the power of t dt. 3 e to the power of t plus c, or 3 e to the power of x over 3 plus c. Number 62. Integral of a to the power of x squared times x dx. It's x. X squared equals t to x dx equals dt. Equals 1 over 2 integral of a to the power of t dt or 1 over 2 a to the power of t over natural ln of a plus c or 1 over 2 a to the power of x squared over natural ln of a plus c. Number 64. We have integral of e to the power of 2x squared dx is integral of e to the power of 4x dx. T is 4x. Dt will be 4dx. All of this equals 1 over 4 integral of e to the power of 4x dx 4x equals 1 over 4 into the power of 4x plus c. Number 66. Integral of e to the power minus 3x dx. C is minus 3x. Dt is minus 3 dx. Equals 1 over 3 integral of e to the power of c dt equals minus 1 over 3 e to the power of t plus c or minus 1 over 3 x plus c. Number 68. Integral of e to the power of x squared plus 4x plus 3 x plus 2 dx. In this case, take t is x squared plus 4x plus 3. Dt is 2 times x plus 2 dx equals 1 over 2 integral of e to the power of t dt or 1 over 2 times e to the power of t plus c is 1 over 2 times e to the power of x squared plus 4x plus 3 plus c. Next number 17. We have integral of e to the power of x dx over 3 plus 4 e to the power of x. T is 3 plus 4 e to the power of x, dt is 4 e to the power of x dx, and in this case we have 1 over 4 integral of dt over t, 4 the expression that stay under the natural logarithm always positive. In this case we can don't write modulus, write only bracket. Number 72. Integral of dx over 1 plus 2x squared, or take c is root of 2x, dt will be equal root of 2 dx, and means we have 1 over root of 2 compensation, integral dt over 1 plus t squared, or 1 over root of 2 arctangent of c plus c, or 1 over root of 2 arctangent of root of 2 times x plus c. Number 74. We have integral of dx over square root of 16 minus 9x squared, or integral of dx over square root of 4 squared minus 3x squared. It is c is 3x, dt is 3 dx, dt over square root of 4 squared minus t squared, which is 1 over 3 arc sine of c over 4 plus c, or 1 over 3 arc sine of 3x over 4 plus c. Next number, the number 76. This integral of dx over 4 plus x squared, or dx over 2 squared plus x squared. It's stable integral. Very easy. 78. integral of dx over 4 minus 9x squared. It is integral of dx over 2 squared minus 3x squared. Here t is 3x, dt is 3dx, this integral 1 over 3, integral of dt over 2 squared minus t squared. Sorry. It is stable integral. That equal to 1 over 2a times natural logarithm of modulus of 2 plus c over 2 minus c plus c or 1 over 12 times natural logarithm of modulus 2 plus 3x over 2 minus 3x plus c. Number 18. Integral of dx over square root of b squared x squared minus a squared equals integral of dx over square root of bx squared minus a squared. Substitute t is bx, means dt is b dx, and our integral equals 1 over b integral of dt over square root of t squared minus a squared, then it's stable integral 1 over b times natural logarithm of c plus the root of c squared minus a squared plus c, or 1 over b times natural logarithm of bx plus square root of b squared x squared minus a squared plus c. Next, 82. We must calculate integral dx over a squared x squared minus c squared. Here we take t is ax and we have 1 over a integral of dt over t squared minus c squared, or 1 over a over 2c times 2c times natural logarithm of t minus c over t plus c. plus capital C 1 over 2ac times natural logarithm of ax minus c over ax plus c plus capital C. Number 18. Integral of x dx over square root of 1 minus x to the power of 4. In this case, we take t is x squared, dt will be 2x dx, and our integral will be equal 1 over 2 integral of dt over square root of 1 minus t squared or 1 over 2 arcsine of c plus c or 1 over 2 arcsine of 2x plus c. Number 86. Integral of e to the power of x dx over square root of 1 minus e to the power of 2x. In this case, we take t is e to the power of x. The t in this case will be equal to e to the power of x dx equals integral of dt over square root of 1 minus t squared or arc sine of t plus c arc sine of e to the power of x plus c. Next number 88. Integral of cosine x dx over a squared plus sine squared of x. We know that derivative of sine is cosine, it means t is sine of x, dt is cosine of x dx, all this equals integral of dt over a squared plus t squared. It is 1 over a arctangent of t plus c or 1 over a arctangent of sine of x over a. Plus C. Number 90. Integral of cosine of x minus x over square root of 1 minus x squared dx. This sum of two integrals are cosine of x dx over this root minus integral of x dx over this root. In the first integral, we take t is arc cosine of x, in this case dt will be dx minus dx over square root of 1 minus x squared And in the second integral, we take t is 1 minus x squared u, maybe. And this du. We have integral of t dt minus integral of plus 1 over 2 integral of du over square root of u, or t squared over 2 plus root of u plus c, and when we substitute, we have our cosine of x squared over 2 plus square root of u is 1 minus x squared under root plus c. It is number 92. Number 92. In this case, we must take t is 1 plus natural logarithm of x, dt will be dx over x, and in this case we have integral of square root of t dt, t to the power of 1 over 2, we have t to the power of 3 over 2 over 3 over 2 plus c, or 2 over 3 square root of t is 1 plus natural logarithm x plus c. Number 94, integral of dx over square root of x and square root of 1 plus square root of x. Take t is 1 plus square root of x, dt in this case will be 1 over 2 square root of x dx, and we have integral to integral of dt over square root of t, or for square root of it's 94, yes, of t plus c, the square root of this 1 plus square root of x plus c. It was 94, next 96. Integral of cosine of x dx over cube root of sine squared of x. T is sine of x, dt is, так я один cosine of x dx. И став один, пожалуйста. Equals. Integral of dt over t to the power of 2 over 3 means t to the power of minus 2 over 3 minus 2 over 3 plus 1, it is 1 over 3, but 3 cube root of c plus c.
Хуже. Рапунцель для деревенскую девочку. Плюс длинный косой.
It is three.
Рапунцель. Похоже.
Похоже. Integral of sine of 2x dx over square root of 1 plus cosine square root of x. Take c is 1 plus cosine square root of x. In this case, dt will be minus 2 cosine of x sine of x dx or minus 2. Sine of 2x dx. Continue. It is integral of minus dt over square root of t. It's minus 2 square root of t. Plus c minus 2 square root of 1 plus cosine square root of x plus c. Number 100. Cube root of tangent square root of x over cosine square root of x dx. We will take t is tangent of x, dt is dx over cosine square root of x. Equals integral of t to the power of 2 over 3 dt. T to the power of 5 over 3 over 5 over 3 plus c or 3 over 5 times tangent to the power of cubed root of tangent power 5 of x plus c. Then integral of the form integral of ax plus b over ax squared plus bx plus c dx. This capital A, this little a, capital B, a little b. And first number 102. Integral of dx over x squared plus 2x plus 5. this integral of dx over x plus 1 squared plus, oh sorry, 2, no, 1 squared plus 4, or 2 squared, it is 1 over 2 arctangent of x plus 1 plus c. X plus 1 over 2, 2. Sorry. It is table integral number 104. Integral of dx over x squared plus 3x plus 1. Equals or not? Integral of dx over x squared plus 2 times x times 3 over 2 plus 3 over 2 squared minus 3 over 2 squared plus 1. It is integral of dx over this the full squared x plus 3 over 2 squared minus 9 over 2 and plus 1, it is minus 7 over 2. Or integral of dx over, maybe not, maybe we take t is x plus 3 over 2, dt is dx. We have integral of dt over t squared minus root of 7 over I mistake 9 over 4 plus 1 minus 9 over 4 plus 1, it's 5 over 4. This here 5 over, oh sorry, 5 over 2 root of 5 squared over 2 squared. Here, true. Yes. It is 1 over 2 times root of 5 over 2 times natural logarithm of t minus root of 5 over 2 over t plus this value. It is one over root of 5 times natural logarithm of modulus. If we multiply both numerator and denominator by 2, we will have 2t minus root of 5 and then 2t plus root of 5. And t In our case, plus 3 over 2. C is x plus 3 over 2. T is x plus 3 over 2. It means 2t is 2x plus 3. Plus C, number 106. It is integral of dz over 2z squared minus 2z plus 1. This 1 equals 1 over 2 integral of dz over z squared minus z plus 1 over 2. Or one over two integral in denominator z squared minus two times z times one over two plus one over two squared, it is four squared minus one over two squared plus one over two. In numerator dz. And we have 1 over 2 integral of dz over z minus 1 over 2 squared minus 1 over 4 plus 1 over 2 plus 1 over 4 equals. Take t is z minus 1 over 2, dt is dz, equals one over two integral dt over t squared plus one over two squared, or one over two over one over two times arctangent of t over one over two plus c tz minus 1 over 2 means arctangent z minus 1 over 2 over 1 over 2 plus c. Multiply both numerator and denominator by 1 over by 2. We have arctangent 2z, just 2z minus 1 plus c. It is answer. It was number 106, next number 108. Integral of 6x minus 7 dx. Over 3x squared minus 7x plus 11. Take c is 3x squared minus 7x plus 11. Dt will be 6x minus 7 dx equals Natural logarithm of modulus of t plus c, or natural logarithm of modulus of 3x squared minus 7x plus 11 plus c. Number 110. Integral of 3x minus 1 over x squared minus x plus 1. If we will differentiate x squared minus x plus 1, we will have 2x minus 1. It means we need 2x minus 1 in numerator. We have 3 integral over 2x minus 1 over 3 times 2 over 3, and we have minus 1 plus 1. And we have 3 over 2 integral of 2x minus 1 dx over x squared minus x plus 1. Plus 3 over 2, and we stay 1 minus 2 over 3 is 1 over 3. Integral of dx over this denominator, x minus 1 over 2 squared plus 3 over 4. Yes. First integral equals natural logarithm of denominator. Denominator always positive, the opposite, I don't say modulus. Next integral, it is arctangent. Of 3 arctangent x minus 1 over 2 over square root of 3 over 2. It is three over two natural logarithm of x squared minus x plus one. Plus 1 over root of 3 arctangent, multiply numerator and denominator by 2. Mm-hmm. Next number. Number 112. Integral of 2x minus 1 over 5x squared minus x plus 2 with respect to x equals if we calculate derivative of denominator, we will have 10x minus 1 dx. And we have 2x minus 1 multiplied by 5, 10x minus 5. Minus 5 is minus 1 minus 4, minus 5. 5x squared minus x plus 2 with respect to x. And divide by 2 integral 1 over 5 times integral of z of 5x squared minus x plus 2 over 5x squared minus x plus 2 minus 4 over 5 integral maybe 1 over 5 to integral of dx over x squared minus x over 5. It's 2x over 10 plus 1 over 10 squared minus 1 over 10 squared and plus 2 over 5. Because 5 we take out. We have the first integral equals natural logarithm of modulus of denominator, but denominator always positive because it don't write modulus, we can write only bracket, and we have 1 over 5 natural logarithm of 5x squared minus x plus 2 minus 4 over 25 integral dx over x minus 1 over 10 squared plus 2 over 5 minus 1 over 100. It's 100. It's 100 over 5. It's 20. Yes, 20 times 2 is 40. 40 minus 1 is 39. Over 100. It's root of 39 squared is 10 squared. And we have arctangent. Dx equals d of x minus 1 over 10. Because it we can calculate, don't use substitute. Here, 1 over 8, it's 10 over root of 39. Arctangent x minus 1 over 10 over root of 39 over 10. Sorry, no mean, please. Plus sin. Multiply numerator and denominator by 10, and we have 1 over 5 times natural logarithm of 5x squared minus x plus 2 minus eight over minus 5 root of 39 of tangent of 10x minus 1 over square root of 39 plus c. Next number 114. Integral of dx over 2 cosine squared of x plus sine of x times cosine of x plus sine squared of x. This integral. Look, this integral equals integral of dx over 2 cosine squared of x, rewrite as cosine squared of x plus cosine squared of x. And cosine square root of x plus sine square root of x will be 1, just 1. Cosine square root of x is 1 over 2 or not? It's 2 times maybe not. I stay now cosine square root of x. Plus sine of x times cosine of x. Then maybe in the denominator, take cosine squared of x out. We will have 1 over 2 plus tangent of x plus tangent squared of x times dx over cosine squared of x. Yes. And substitute, t is tangent of x. In this case, dt will be dx over cosine squared of x. This integral of dt over 2 plus t squared. Yes, good. Then calculate integral of dt over t squared plus 2t times 1 over 2 plus 1 over 2 squared minus 1 over 2 squared plus 2. It means we have integral of dt over t plus 1 over 2 squared plus 1 over 4 plus 8 over 4 is 7 over 4. This. And we have 2 over square root of 7 arctangent. T plus 1 over 2 over square root of 7 over 2. Multiply both numerator and denominator by 2 and do inverse substitution. We have 2 over square root of 7 times arctangent of 2t plus 1. T is tangent of x. 2 tangent of x plus 1 over square root of 7 plus c. It is answer. Next series of examples, integrals of the form, write down integrals of the form integral of ax plus b over square root of ax squared plus bx plus c dx. The first number of this series is number 116. Integral of dx over square root of 1 plus x squared. Consider this integral in the form dx over square root of x plus 1 over 2 squared and plus 3 over 4. Take t is x plus 1 over 2, dt will be equal to dx, and our integral equals integral of dx over square root of t squared plus 3 over 4. It is table dt, sorry, table integral that named the long logarithm. It is natural logarithm of modulus t plus its root. Plus arbitrary constant c on natural logarithm t is x plus 4, x plus 1 over 2 plus square root of 1 plus x plus x squared. Close modulus plus c. Number 180. Integral of dx over square root of 2 minus 3x minus 4x squared. It is integral of dx over, maybe 1 over 2, I take out this integral and we have integral of 1 over 2 plus 3, oh, minus, sorry, minus 3x squared plus 3 over 4. It is 2x times 3 over 8 plus 3 over 8 squared plus 3 over 8 squared. Yes. Close our square root. Equals 1 over 2 times integral dx over square root of 3 over 8 squared is 9 over 64. 1 over 2 plus 9 over 64. It's 64 plus 9 over 64. 64 plus 9 is 73. 73. Over 64. Oh, not 64 plus 9. 1 over 2 is 32 over 64. 32 plus 9. It is 41. 41. Good. Minus x plus 3/8 squared. Take t is x plus 3/8. The t is dx, and we have integral 1/2 dx over dt over square root of 41/64 minus t squared. It is cosine. Sine of c over 41 square root times 8. Plus c and inverse substitution of sine of 8t. It's 8x plus 3 over square root of 41 plus arbitrary constant c. Next number. It was number 115. Next number 120. Integral of dx over square root of 2 minus 3x minus x squared. Calculate integral under power square root. X squared plus 2x times 3/2 plus 3/2 squared and plus 9/4. And here too. Good. Dx equals 9/4 plus 8/4 is 17/4. And it means we have dx over square root of 17/4 minus x plus 3/2 squared. It's cosine again, but in the first we substitute c is x plus 3/2. Dt is dx. We have integral of dt over square root of 17/2 squared minus t squared, or just arc sine c over square root of 17 over 2 plus c. C is x plus 3 over 2 times 2 is 2x plus 3, and we have arcsine of 2x plus 3 over square root of 17 plus c. Number 122. Integral of 2ax plus b over square root of ax squared plus bx plus c with respect to x equals, if we make the substitution, c is ax squared plus bx plus c, we will have differential of our c is 2ax plus b dx, where stay on numerator in our fraction. This integral of dc over square root of t or 2 square root of t plus c 2 square root of ax squared plus bx plus c plus arbitrary constant capital C, the little c capital C, different c. Next number 124. Integral of x minus 3 dx over square root of 3 plus 66x minus 11x squared. Same way, c is 3 plus 66x minus 11x squared. In this case, dt will be equal to 66 minus 22x dx, or minus 22x minus 3 dx. It means our integral will be equal to minus 1 over 22 integral of dt over square root of t, or minus 1 over 22 times 2 square root of t plus c. Or if we put t is 3 plus 66x minus 11x squared, we will have minus 1 over 11 times square root of 3 plus 66x minus 11x squared plus arbitrary constant c. Number 126. Integral of 3x plus 5 over square root of x times 2x plus 1 with respect to x on integral 3x plus 5 dx over square root of 2x plus x. If we find differential of 2x squared plus x, we will have 4x plus 1 dx. It means we need 2x plus 1 in our denominator. Equals 3 over 4 integral 4x plus 5 times 4 over 3 plus 1 minus 1 over this root. And for x plus 1, we take in the first integral and in the second integral we stay other terms. Yeah, integral plus 5 times 4, 20 over 3 minus 3 over 3 is 17 over 3. That's 17 over 3 integral of dx over square root of 2x squared plus x equals. In the first integral, if we take t is 2x squared plus x, we have integral of dt over square root of t or 2 square root of t. And in the end, 3 over 4 times 2 square root of t. Good. Here, plus 17 over 4 times I take out square root of 2. And here I have square root of x squared plus x over 2 or x squared plus 2 x over 4 plus 1 over 16 minus 1 over 16. Here the x. Take t is x squared plus 1. Oh, sorry. X plus 1 over 4. Dt is dx. And we will have 3 over 2 times square root of x squared plus x plus 17 over 4 square root of 2 times integral dc over square root of t squared minus 1 over 16. It's long over 3 over 2 square root plus 17 over 4 square root of 2 times natural logarithm of the sum t plus this root. Plus arbitrary constant c. And if we make the inverse substitute, t is x plus 1 over 4, we will have 3 over 2 times square root of 2x squared plus x plus 17 over 4 times square root of 2 times natural logarithm of modulus x plus 1 over 4 plus square root of x squared plus x over 2. Plus arbitrary constant c. In this moment, we end our class at home. You must solve number from 18 7 plus not 15 4 to 101 from page 389 goodbye.